Hi everyone, this is Rachel. Today I'm going to show you how to quickly and interactively extract spectral features from some rotating machinery signal data, and then trace those features back to specific components. This is a key step in doing predictive maintenance and can help detect and isolate faults in rotational equipment. We'll start with time series data from a gear train that's connected to a DC motor in healthy and faulty operation. Our goal here is really to extract features from this data to help identify faults in a gear train. We'll use a new Live Editor task to do this interactively, creating features that will help us compare healthy and faulty behavior of individual components. Here's what our motor data collection setup looks like. The important thing to note here is the gear train, which consists of four pairs of rigidly connected gears and pinions. You can see from the table how the output speed changes across each gear reduction. Remember, our goal today is to extract features from our motor data that we can use to tell us which gear might be faulty. We cover this example in a lot more detail in the Predictive Maintenance Toolbox documentation, so you can check that out for a more in-depth overview of the hardware setup. So let's go over to MATLAB. I'll start by loading in the healthy and faulty data sets. Each data set is a timetable with motor current and the tachometer pulse that we can use to determine motor RPMs. Let's look at the power spectrum for each data set first. It looks like the peak locations are different, both in terms of frequency as well as magnitude. We can associate these peaks with each of the rotating shafts in our gear train. To do this, we will use a Live Editor task. A Live Editor task is an app that can be added to a live script in MATLAB, so we can do some common operations interactively without writing any code. We'll use the Extract Spectral Features Live task, which is new in 2021A. We'll start by analyzing the healthy data only. Select the frequency and magnitude vectors, and then we'll add each shaft as a custom component. I could also analyze gear meshes and bearings. The first shaft had a fundamental frequency of 90.24 Hertz. We can look at a few harmonics too, maybe the first six. These seem to correspond pretty well to each of the major peaks in the spectrum here. We can also adjust the width of the bands to account for some variations in frequency due to RPM changes. To account for the lower frequency peaks, let's add in components for the second and third shafts, which operate at lower frequencies. We'll only choose the harmonics that overlay with the peaks in our spectrum. If we zoom in on the plot, we can see some side peaks next to some of the major peaks, which are caused by a related frequency source, in this case, the next shaft in the gear train. So let's add in the sidebands for shafts 1 and 2. We'll use the prior shaft frequency as the separation. We can see that they overlay pretty well. Once we're happy with our fault bands, we can export the spectral metrics, which contain values such as peak frequency and amplitude. We now need to repeat this process for the faulty data to compare the results. We'll first calculate the faulty shaft speeds from the tachometer readings. We could do this with the interactive live task, just as we did with the healthy data, or if I want to automate the process or I have a lot of data, I could generate the MATLAB code behind the scenes and repeat everything that I just did interactively. Comparing the metrics for healthy and faulty performance, we can see clear changes in the peak frequencies and amplitudes. Since each of these metrics is associated with a component in our gear train, if we see a change in a metric, we can use that to identify a fault. To learn more about this example or see other new features in Predictive Maintenance Toolbox, visit our documentation in the links provided below. Thanks for listening.